Welcome and happy holidays from 2K Sports. It's time for NBA action. Hi, everyone. Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and we have David Aldridge on our sideline. And our special guest tonight, welcoming in Kenny the Jet Smith.
Oh, Kevin, man, great to be here. I hate being up in that studio sometimes. I love it down here,
we
man.
We need you courtside.
Oh,
we
man,
need you
it
courtside.
Feels so much better being with you guys and the mother, too.
Let's check out the Western Conference standings right now that we're here in the new year. You take a look at the Kings, fourth in the conference, an excellent season so far for them, though they'd like to jump into the top tier, maybe the top three. And, of course, there's the Rockets. They're much further down in the standings right now.
And checking out Sacramento, this hasn't been the breakout season that many were predicting, but they're still very much in the hunt for a high postseason seed, and that will keep them focused here during the season's final stages.
And they need to stay focused. I mean, they have to ensure they hang on to a high seed. It's imperative for them.
Let's take a look at our starters for Sacramento. The front court will be Barnes along with Bagley. In the back court, it's Fox and Heald, and it's Holmes in at the center. And for the Rockets,
here we go.
They've got P.J. Tucker, Wall out there with Harden. Then it's Christian Wood, and it's House in at the three spot.
And the great teams have those superstar players. Kenny, you played alongside the great Hakeem Olajuwon, and this Rockets team is built around another great one in James Harden.
Yep, both of them, you know, they're able to put their team on the back offensively, but Hakeem was able to do it defensively as well. But offensively, the Beard is a phenomenal scorer and creator.
Now Wall. Following De'Aaron Fox's three-point attempt, 2 points, that one goes.
You know, one of the things I like about Walton is he really takes on the defense, plays downhill. When he's driving inside, he is committed to scoring over the defense.
Now here's Barnes. His last outing, he had 24 points. Shoots the three. No good there. The Rockets go the other way with it. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
And guys, they walked into the arena with a certain kind of swagger, and we really saw it play out on the offensive end.
And you know, confidence is key there. They seem to play with a ton of it, especially on the offensive end.
The Rockets shooting their first free throw of the game here.
And look back a season ago. They did a solid job at the line, about 79% of their free throws.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
About a minute played so far here in the first. On the wing, Barnes. Pass to Holmes. Count the basket.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now, here is Harden. He had a 33-point outing in their last game against Sacramento.
And even while he was piling up all those points, he still found a way to create chances for his teammates. The assists just kept on coming.
Strange, the three-pointer. We hear all these different terms about resting players, but Kenny, load management seems to be the one that is stuck. Is that something you wish was around, for instance, when you played?
Honestly, I probably didn't want it, but if I used it, oh, I would have been a much better player, honestly. Because your body is at 170 pounds, 6'3", is not built to play 82 games in playoffs. It's not built for that. Your body's just not meant for that. So, yes, I might have been, Greg, I might have been in a couple All-Stars, man, yeah. I think, man. I could have done some things.
But wasn't there pride in players in playing 82 games?
In all reality, the pride was in you had to work for that next contract. The dollars are such now that it's an investment for the team that they're trying to protect. So it means as much for them to make sure you're rested and ready to go, to Kenny's point, as it does to you.
Here's Heald. James Harden picking up that last basket. Heald, the pass to Holmes. Kicks it to Barnes. Six to shoot. Three-pointer, Heald. It's hauled in by Wood. For the Sacramento Kings, Their last game, a loss to Houston.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost them.
And you know what, guys? It just seemed like they never really had the kind of energy necessary. They just weren't comfortable on the defensive end.
And here is Holmes. James Harden getting it to go from deep. Back to Barnes. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Barnes has got five.
Over the last few years, Jet, the step back three has become a staple for some guys. Who do you think is the most consistent with it?
Harden and Doncic, easily. You know who started the Dutch step back? A guy named, and the first time I ever saw it was Kiki Vander.
Yeah. Oh, really?
I never saw a step back until he
and
played.
It was quick.
Yeah, he used to do a quick step back. And I'd never seen the step back move ever in my life before. And I was like, what is that? Is that a walk? And he's like, no, it's a step back. And now we got the step to the step to the step to the step to the step back.
Inside back.
And what's going to be the next development?
Oh, you're just going to be able to run and you don't have to jump.
Yeah. We're seeing that right now.
Yeah, exactly.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
On the wing, Barnes. He has five. Driving in. It's rebounded by Houston.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Tucker. No good on that one. Great D that time from Bagley. On the wing, Barnes. Outside, Fox. Wall grabs the board.
Well, you know, stopping him is never easy to do, but the defense was strong there.
And Wall slams it home.
Tell you one thing, it's a bonus to have a guard who can flush it like that. I mean, Wall gets up high on these jams.
Kenny, you watched the NBA for so long. What are some things you find that make successful front offices in this league?
You can't be lazy. You got to get on the road.
The guys aren't lazy.
There's some guys there, I'm telling you. You can't be lazy. You got to be on that road. You have to understand. It's easy to see kids at Duke, North Carolina, Kentucky. But have you gone to Europe or yourself as a general manager? Have you gone in the mid-major level and been at games when there's only 1,500 in the stands, but there's Paul George playing? Yeah. Like, have you found him? That's not lazy.
And the thing he's calling lazy, honestly, is being complacent. And the other thing you got to be, quite frankly, you got to get lucky. You know, you got to get a Kawhi, and you got to get a Giannis, or you got to get a superstar caliber player that allows you to build around. Yes. Otherwise, man, it's going to be a challenge.
And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Kings. Robinson passes to Halliburton. Back to Robinson. Whiteside, a screen on Brown. Robinson drives in. The slam dunk by Robinson.
The finish was nice, but the setup was better.
Yeah, G.A., the pick working to full effect before the stuff.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look, and that's exactly how you draw it up.
Brown outside. And it's Sacramento with the rebound.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Yeah, the half and half balls are going their way, and that's really a function of effort and intensity. You know, the ball doesn't discriminate. Whoever goes and gets it, that's who owns it.
And the score, the likes of James Harden, it seems like he's broken it down to a science.
Yes, footwork, create space, and be a heck of a shooter.
Did you look at the way you played, Kenny, as science, like we're talking about here with Harden?
Not maybe as easily observed as he is, but I had a game plan. I'm like, I'm going to get it from free throw line to free throw line as fast as I can. That's my first thought. I'm going to, on pick and rolls, get 2 feet in the paint. That's my second. And every inch that you give me at the three-point line, I'm letting it go.
I love that answer.
And it's a great approach. And this guy, he really has mastered the game in terms of just his overall approach to scoring the basketball. And I tell you another thing, I've never seen a guy with the degree of difficulty for his complete arsenal. You never see him just get an uncontested layup or catch and shoot three. Everything he has to create.
Well, he's certainly been on target with the free throws. Such an advantage when your bigs can knock them down from the line.
Here's Wall. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good. Wall's got 8 points. The Kings trail by three. Now, here is Halliburton. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. They get it again. Another shot. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
And the double clutch layup in that situation, that's just him playing to the crowd, guys.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
That mid-range shot has been a weapon for them up to this point, fellas.
You know, it also hasn't taken them long to make their mark in the paint. I mean, they're doing a lot of their scoring from in there.
And it's tied up with that one. We've got 1:23 left here in the first quarter. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, I did catch up with Coach Luke Walton. He knows that John Wall presents a challenge for them, especially when he can get inside. Coach said, Wall is such a fantastic finisher, you have to do your work early, out on the perimeter. Once he gets by you, it's already too late. So they'll have to do everything they can to keep defenders in front of him. Guys?
Okay, David, much appreciated.
One shot.
And that one misses.
Hard not to appreciate the brilliance of Wall. I mean, a super fast, quick player, a guy who runs the offense exceedingly well.
Now, here is Halliburton. And the dunk by Robinson.
Now, flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
Does it as well as anybody, fellas. Tremendous skill while in the air.
Wall, and the slam dunk by Wall.
I'll tell you, when Wall is scoring like this, it's special to watch. A spectacular, explosive performance.
Now, here's Joseph. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Up again. It's good on the putback.
There you go. Relentless pursuit of the ball. I love it. He never stopped working.
And so it's Wall with it, bringing it up for the Rockets. Three-pointer. That shot, no good. And it's the Kings taking it the other way. 1 second separate in the shot clock and game clock. And here's Halliburton. To the middle. A miss that time. Would have put him up. With one on the clock. Doesn't get it to drop for him. John Wall getting it done for Houston. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. And we've got more NBA action on 2K Sports coming your way after this break. Naturally a ball-dominant player, James Harden talked to us about others setting him up a little bit more.
Yeah, that's the goal. Of course, I'm playing off the ball is something that I'm comfortable doing. Like, I'm able to catch and shoot. I'm able to play off, you know, on the wings.
Giving their offense another dynamic.
And it also helps him preserve some energy for those big moments in the big games.
And some good action in the books as we get back to the game that's been pretty close here so far. And when you consider how the Rockets are doing, guys, what do you think?
Well, in that first quarter, they were intent on just pounding the ball down low.
Yeah, and it's worked. They've got a clear edge and points in the paint. Now we'll see if they go with a more balanced attack or just keep on pounding it inside.
On the court for Sacramento, filling out the wing spots, it'll be Hield and Barnes. Bagley and Holmes sharing the post duties. And it's Fox in at the one. And they now lead as the free throw drops for him. Now, Hakeem Olajuwon had the dream shake, but the step back for James Harden, one of those moves, Kenny, that just seems unstoppable.
How crazy is that, Kenny?
I know.
Two guys from the same franchise.
Same team.
Are going to have the two most iconic moves possibly in NBA history. The dream shake and the James Harden sidestep.
Harden's added to it, Ed. He's kind of given a new little nuance.
You know, when I say this, people sometimes get it confused with saying how great the player is, but from an offensive standpoint, his total package is arguably as good as we've seen. Because people forget, he's a top five passer in our league, too. He's a great passer as well as getting you 38 a night.
Boy, excellent recognition from Fox there. Outstanding at recognizing when his guys are open.
Harden outside, the three. The Rockets with another miss.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Yeah, tit for tat on the glass. Just one more aspect of what's been a very closely contested ball game here.
Healed from outside. Good, and a nice assist from Fox. Fox has got his third assist on the night.
And you've got to be up on Hield, especially when he's beyond the arc. If not, he'll burn you.
And here's Harden for three. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Harden. Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that Mobile One block.
And they're determined to add to the lead, not with more offense, but with big-time D.
Kings leading now by seven. Kenny, these days you need versatile defenders. In your opinion, who does the best job of guarding from point guard to center in the NBA?
You got Kawhi, you got AD. I would add Paul George in the mix.
Sure.
I would add Patrick Beverley in the mix. I would add P.J. Tucker, guys who can play multiple defending positions.
Avery Bradley.
I would add him in there. You notice most of them on the same team, huh?
Yeah, they are.
That's crazy.
Kenny, you played under a number of legendary coaches. What traits do they share, and how were they different?
Well, the great thing about all of them, they had me. So that made
them, check that box, right? Move half off to the side.
It's something that they all had in common. I'm not saying that it's me, but it is him. I think what makes them great. What makes them great is the ability to relate, and also the ability to change direction. Like, you could have a game plan and then all of a sudden change the game plan in the middle of the game and come up with a new one if it's not working.
Well, I even go a step further. You're also, the great coaches adapt to their personnel as opposed to trying to make the personnel adapt to them. That's why Greg Popovich stand out for me. Because I remember when the Spurs used to be beating you in the 80s.
Yeah. And now?
Man, he's the guy that started
this
running. Whole offensive
yep. thing. Yep, he's running thing.
Now, here's Fox. Harden missing his last shot. Outside, Bagley.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, we all know that there are some people who dislike James Harden's style of play. They're bored watching him shoot free throws. He said, "I see how teams guard me and find ways to exploit it. I just outthink the game, and I'm faulted for it." Kevin, that may be, but it's hard to argue with the results. Back to you.
You're right. One of the top scorers in league history, David. Thanks for that report.
Have to rush Harden off that line. He's downright lethal from out there.
And the Kings with possession. They're on a 15-5 run. On the wing, Barnes. Holmes against Wood. Holmes can't get it to go in. Rockets trail by 10. Harden kicks to Wood. The pass to House. Shot clock at 5. And the basket by Gordon.
Boy, Gordon sends that one straight down and in from beyond the arc.
And so Fox will bring it up for the Sacramento Kings. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Passes it to Bagley. Barnes outside. Launches a 3. Rebounded by Tucker.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
Wood finds Harden. Takes the 3. And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
He's certainly starting to heat up from outside. That's his 3rd for the game, his 2nd in this quarter.
Timeout called by the Kings.
They're trying to stem the tide here.
Yeah, you know, they had to do something, anything, to stop this run. You can't just let it go on any longer.
Both teams deciding to change it up. Well, while we have a second, let's show you the list of players who put up the most points last year. James Harden, number 1.
And he's not going to forget that season anytime soon. And it's safe to say neither will anyone who watched him.
Pass to Bielitsa. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's on DeMarcus Cousins. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Kings.
Guys, they are dialed in from beyond right now. They didn't waste any time getting into a groove in this game.
Well, the job of penetrating that they've done so far has really been excellent. I mean, they've done a nice job driving to the hoop effectively.
He's off on the first. And the 2nd free throw, good. Rockets trail by 5. Right side Wall. That's good again. His 7th basket, 7-for-10 from the floor.
Inside, outside, it doesn't matter. Like how Wall attacks and looks to score when the opportunity presents itself.
The Rockets have gone 5-of-11 from the field since the beginning of the 2nd quarter. Joseph against Harden. And it's blocked by Whiteside.
And Whiteside takes great pride in rejecting shots. Outstanding at getting his arms up and denying shooters.
Here's Halliburton. Outside, Joseph. Now, here's Halliburton, covered by Wall. And that's good. A nice job in the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
Yeah, and the presence of Whiteside in the paint, really unreal. He is a dominant figure down low. Great work to grab that second chance opportunity.
Tate, the pass to Wall. And he banks in the layup. Wall's got it all tied up now for the Rockets.
Beautiful pick by the big man, Cousins.
Outside, Joseph. Pass to Halliburton. Right side inside. He's guarded by Cousins. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. It's on DeMarcus Cousins. For Sacramento, they have missed two free throws in the game, going 5 for 7.
And last season, 77% from the line. They could usually get the job done there.
That free throw, no good.
You know, guys, you've got to give much respect to the length of Whiteside. I mean, he's a hulking 7-footer who takes a lot of pride in being the defensive anchor for this team.
Sterling Brown is checked in for James Harden. And he hits the second from the line. And it's Wall with the ball for Houston. At the elbow, it's Cousins. Brown outside. That one's in, his first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
And the defense, no factor, which is why he simply laid it in.
And what about our special guest? Kenny, thanks for taking the time to join us, dropping by. Always a pleasure. You add so much to the broadcast.
Man, thanks for having me. This is just great.
Thank you. And Clark, has there ever been a smoother transition from on-court star to broadcast mainstay than what we've seen and heard with Kenny Smith?
Very much like his game, Kenny Smith smoothly stepping from the court to the broadcast booth. And, you know, he's been fantastic in his role with the NBA as a broadcaster. And, you know, he's been part of the NBA family for decades now, and he's done it at a high level.
Here's Robinson, following the basket by DeMarcus Cousins. Whiteside, a screen on Brown. Joseph, that's good.
Far from just a jump shooter, Joseph is not shy at getting inside and making it happen there.
Outside, Wall. The pass to Nwaba. He feeds it to Cousins. The rebound by Halliburton. Up in time. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Rockets lead by 1. We'll be back shortly live from Houston, Texas.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it.
And gracing us with his presence once again after his stirring performance with the live crew, at least that's what the card I'm reading says, and it was written by the always terrific Kenny Smith.
Well, you know what it was. You called it the live crew, but you know what it was when I was down there?
No.
You know it's always fun.
You know what, Kenny?
Yes,
I'm not a hater. I'm a congratulator.
Thank you.
And I must say, you did a great job. I liked it almost as much as the regular broadcast. Right. I was impressed.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. An exceptional performance from John Wall.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. They've got Christian Wood. Harden out there with Wall. Then it's P.J. Tucker, and it's House in at the three, the small forward. So that's who's on the floor for the Rockets. And here's Harden for three. Sacramento's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them.
And Clark, when you look at the footwork of James Harden, arguably some of the best in the history of this league.
And you know, Greg, he studied the greats. I mean, he loved Ginobili's Euro step and then added it to his own game. Now he's taking that to another level, and he's the one giving out the lessons. But you're right, got great strength, but the footwork is really outstanding.
Now here's Barnes, following the miss shot by Rashawn Holmes. And it's Harrison Barnes with the foul. That's his first foul.
Yeah, way to get there first and be willing to absorb the contact.
No question about it. No flop there. That was a direct shot to the chest.
Houston in the lead. Harden with it. He's got 13. Looking to get back on track here. And Harden with the stuff.
Yeah, that barrel-chestedness of Harden's. So much strength and body control. It's hard to stop him from scoring.
Holmes kicks to Heald. Bagley sends a screen for Heald. Chalk up two there. Heald's got 8 points.
And no one knows their job better than Heald to energize the offense, handle a big chunk of that scoring load.
Here's Wall. Good work defensively by Fox. And it's Barnes with the ball for the Sacramento Kings. Holmes finds Heald. Barnes screen on Wood. Heald against Wood. 6 on the shot clock for the lead. It doesn't go for him. The Rockets go the other way with it. In the corner, Harden. No good from outside. The Kings have gotten just one of their first 4 shots to fall since coming out of the locker room at the break. It's Holmes, high post. Back to Fox. Now here's Heald. He's guarded close and out of bounds as the Rockets gain possession. Here's what the Houston Rockets schedule looks like. On Monday, they'll go up against Kristaps Porzingis and the Dallas Mavericks. And then on Wednesday, they'll be taking on Victor Oladipo and the Indiana Pacers. Now, here's Tucker. No points in the game yet for him. Rebounded by Holmes. Holmes got rebound number 5 here tonight. Fox passes to Holmes. Sacramento moving it around. He kicks it to Heal. Dishes it to Barnes. Again, the miss by the Kings.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
Down low. Now, here's Tucker, covered by Barnes. Good on the shot. Greg, who would you choose as the best defenders of the NBA pick and roll? Oof.
That is a tough one. This will surprise some people. Nikola Jokic is one of the better big men defending the pick and roll, in part because of his instincts. You know, he doesn't impress me in terms of his physical attributes, but his mind, the ability to anticipate, having a sense of how perimeter players play the game, he's a guy that's terrific. I'll give you an oldie but goodie in Andre Iguodala. He's still terrific. And I pick bigger guys because you've got to be able to switch that and guard smaller players. And you know, at the center and in the swing position, those are two guys that still are very reliable.
Fox. Sacramento gets it back in a new 14. It's good. Heald's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
I certainly do. You know, I like to see guys do their work inside. Their rebounding has been excellent, and that's always important in a close game.
Sacramento's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Passes to Barnes. Healed outside. Again, Healed missing.
You know, he just has not been himself this period. Just too inconsistent, up and down at the offensive end.
Tucker dishes to House. Here's Wall. Barnes grabs the miss.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
Here's Bagley. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Bagley's got his third basket of the night right there. Timeout call for Rockets.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
Houston making some changes. DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Wood. David Mwabot comes in for P.J. Tucker. And Gordon subbed in for Danuel House. Sacramento on defense. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. Good work there as it goes. Harden's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Great focus from the clever guard, James Harden. I mean, so good at staying with his shot, even under duress.
And it's kind of the running joke when you think of James Harden, often maligned for his lack of effort defensively. But quite honestly, I thought he improved a great deal a season ago.
And, you know, Greg, I observed the same thing. His overall commitment was better. And not just steals and blocks either. I'm just talking about his awareness, his commitment to that end of the floor. It was a focal point. If he continues on that track, I think he's going to make an impact at that end as well.
And here are the Kings now. The Rockets making the shot. Joseph looking over the floor. And there's a whistle that goes on Corey Joseph. That is his first foul of the game.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
Heads up action there. Reading the play and then beating him to the spot. Well done.
Brown is checked in for the Rockets. And so Cousins will bring it up for Houston. They lead by one. The three from Harden. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. Whiteside's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
No luck for him this half after being outstanding from outside the arc in the first half.
Now here is Robinson. Whiteside trying to break free. He elites and misses.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Here's Gordon. Pass to Harden. And the ball out of play. The Kings will inbound. Now that we have a chance, let's go to the 2K leaderboard and reveal last season's top shot blockers. Hassan Whiteside on top.
It happened so often. I'd say to myself, there's no way he can get to that shot. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, and it go down as another block.
Now, here is Halliburton. Now the dish to Whiteside. Pass to Halliburton. And there's the drive. Whiteside, good. Whiteside's got 9 points.
Boy, he's been a rock of offensive support so far. And when they've needed a basket, they've turned to him.
It's Harden with the drive. And the Kings pushing it up now. Here's Halliburton. It's good. Now it's a 3-point Sacramento lead.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
At the elbow, it's Cousins over Whiteside. And there's DeMarcus Cousins on the assist by Harden. Cousins has got 4 points in the quarter.
Cousins has such a nice stroke, and he does a really good job of concentrating through excellent defense to get that shot down.
Joseph with the ball, and it's Gordon picking him up, and there's a whistle that goes on Corey Joseph. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Yeah, really good defensive play to cut him off there and square up.
Excellent example of toughness and physicality on defense. Got his nose right in the middle of things and made a play.
Here is Harden. Takes a three. That one doesn't go. And he drains the three, but let's see. They may need to review it. I'm not sure the ball was out of his hand in time. Well, we thought the third quarter was over, but it turns out the officials are going to review the play to see if he released the ball before the buzzer.
And they're making sure on this one, even though it may not matter in the grand scheme, but the replay process is faster than ever. You know, why not?
Yeah, the replay center in Secaucus is providing the officials with the necessary footage to make the call. We're seeing what they're seeing with the best possible angles.
And it looks like they got it right this time. No basket. The clock had expired while the ball was still in his hand.
Yeah, and even if they don't show it, I know the refs are proud of themselves after a replay proves them right. They're like, see, we had it right all along. So good call, fellas.
And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. It's Sacramento leading by just one. And we'll be back with you right after this. Let's listen now to head coach Luke Walton review the game plan with his team.
If we just keep moving it, it's not a bad shot. But if we move it, cut, they will break down. We'll get open layups. Let's go. Come on, stay. Keep doing them.
Well, Coach Walton, preaching patience and ball movement.
And eventually, Kevin, if you work the ball around, you're going to find holes in that defense.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. On the floor for Sacramento, we've got Fox. Rashawn Holmes out there with Harrison Barnes. Then it's Halliburton, and it's Heald in at the three. Shot by Gordon, wide open, and it's good off the back rim and in. Gordon's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Rockets. The Kings trailing. Holmes setting the big for Fox. With the fadeaway. And the rejection by Cousins.
Cousins not one to be challenged there. Tenacious denial.
Here's Holmes. And finally, that one's good. And the Kings lead by one.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
You know, Cousins is not the guy you want to put on the line because he's a pretty good foul shooter for a big guy.
And that one falls for DeMarcus Cousins.
Yeah, you know, you go back to when Cousins was drafted, and there were some that questioned his attitude, but lately, I don't think that's the case anymore.
And the Kings making a change here. Bagley's checked in. So DeMarcus Cousins nails both of them. Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. On the wing, Barnes. Here's Heald. Count it. Number five from the four this game. He's now 5 of 11.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from the paint.
In the corner, it's Gordon. House the pass to Cousins. Wall against Fox. Wall, no luck. And it's Fox with the ball for the Kings. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Here's Heald. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Well, Buddy Heald, the consummate gym rat. Growing up in the Bahamas, he built his own rim with a milk crate and would shoot all night. His neighbors got so tired of yelling at him to keep it down, he sprinkled broken glass under the rim to get him to move the hoop.
And he knocks down the first one. And Greg, they said Heald would wait until his mom fell asleep and then sneak out to play basketball. And when she came looking for him, he'd take off running.
Yeah, he preferred to catch that discipline at home more so than in public. But growing up in the 8 Mile Rock, a tough neighborhood, his mom rightfully very protective.
No good on the second free throw.
Well, they should be looking at a 3-point lead. Hopefully for them, that miss won't cost them.
Wall looking it over. Here's Wood, and good, coming off the assist by Wall. Wood's got the game tied up here for the Rockets.
Yeah, you know, John Wall is so masterful as a floor general. He's a real maestro out there, terrific at finding the open guy on time and on target.
Good ball movement here by the Kings. Shot clock at 6. Got a piece of it. Barnes outside, and that one drops. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Outside, Wall, and there's the pass to Gordon. Off target from outside.
I wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the backboard.
It's clearly been their edge, and in a close game like this, you look for every edge you can find.
Shot by Heald, nobody around, drills the three-pointer. Now it's a 5-point Sacramento lead. For Houston, they've gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Here's Gordon. Rebound by the Kings. Holmes got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. Great offensive performance they're putting on.
And guys, we call that the zone because that's where they are right now. They are in a zone, and I'm sure they feel unstoppable. Efficiency has been the hallmark right now down the stretch. He is making the most of his opportunity.
Ball passes to Gordon. Here's Wood, guarded by Holmes. Throws it up high and finished off by Wood.
And maybe that'll trigger them. Impossible not to get pumped up after that.
Yeah, well, you can see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are pumped up.
And that's what those alley-oops will do for a team. Ignition switch ignited.
Here's Fox. The Rockets making the shot. Bagley the pass to Barnes. Off target from three-point range.
And, you know, even though they're on top, they're winning. I mean, they could use more from him. Trying to shut the door on this one.
Here's Wall. From down in the low post, it goes. Now just a 3-point Sacramento lead. Kings have gone 5 of 10, 50% from the field. On the wing, Barnes. Back to Fox. Pass to Heald. Now here's Bagley. Offensive rebound. Count it. Barnes has got 4 points this quarter.
Barnes is strong and athletic, aggressive on the glass, not afraid to get in there and mix it up.
Rockets have gone 4 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Now a timeout called by Houston. Well, Harrison Barnes at 6'8", 225 has played some power forward. Greg, do you like him there or at his more natural small forward position?
I think in today's game, Kevin, having the strength he does allows him to kind of hold his own. You know, you don't see a lot of four men playing a lot of post-up in today's game. He's still got to be able to play in space, and I think creates matchup nightmares for the opponent.
And now we present our New Balance player of the game, Buddy Hield.
And to me, the best part of his game has been the work he's done inside. I mean, slashing, driving the lane, attacking the basket at every chance. When he's had an opening, he's taken it.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, guys. Well, the Rockets coach had some words for his team during the timeout. His concern was both their inconsistency and their amount of three-point shots. He said, let's move the ball for good shots. If you have an open three, take it. Otherwise, let's attack the rim and put some pressure on these guys. Kevin?
And Harden, an absolutely vicious dunker. Terrific at bouncing towards the rim for the epic throwdown.
Fox kicks to Holmes. On the wing, Barnes. Back to Hield. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. Knocks it loose. And it's the Kings with the ball. Beyond the arc. Rockets with the rebound.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax cut.
Oh my goodness! That was special! And I think one of the things understated about Harden, he's a great athlete. I mean, he can rise and bounce. He's strong. He's quick. He can easily punch it on you when he gets to the rim.
Now here's Hield. Holmes with a screen on Harden. Wood with the block. Holmes, good. Now Harden. Well, it's definitely within striking distance now.
Yeah, but they've got to make each possession count on both sides of the floor.
Good D by Hield. Kings leading now by three. He dishes it to Barnes. Good on the three-point shot. Barnes has got 7 points here in this quarter.
Hey, when you lay off of Harrison Barnes, he's going to go right up on the catch.
Now here's Harden. Wood a screen on heel. Harden hangs in midair and converts on the double clutch layup. Harden's got 10 points in just the second half. Harden against Hield. Holmes setting the pick for Hield. And it's off from three-point range. Harden against Hield. Harden outside. Here he goes. It drops. And he has brought them to within 2 points.
This is exactly what happens when you allow James Harden to heat up.
Hield against Harden. Holmes with a screen on Harden. Outside, Bagley. Rocket six. Fox dishes to Bagley. A three from Barnes. Knocks down the three.
So many of the plays they're running designed to create opportunities from deep.
Well, you know, that's exactly their plan here in the fourth. Work to find space behind the arc and then bury some threes.
Halliburton's checked in for De'Aaron Fox. Pass to Wood. And some nice passing there by Houston. Kept alive. Here's Wall. Yes! What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
Well, I love the way he goes after it there. I mean, you've got to respect that. He's rewarded for his efforts of pursuing the ball.
And now we've got the intentional foul. Now a timeout called by Sacramento. They're up by three. 26 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And now another look at that mobile one block defensive performance.
The defensive awareness, the timing, when you have to face a defender that can reject you like that, it can alter your approach.
Halliburton passes to Hield, and now they decide to foul intentionally. It's the first, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
We all know Hield can shoot it, but for him to get better, he's got to keep adding different dimensions to his game.
And he cannot convert on the second. That misses.
Can't waste any time here.
No, you need a quick bucket and then a quick foul.
Wall, no luck. And they need to stop the clock, so there's a foul.
Had to foul, and on that occasion to stop the clock, that's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what? Who knows? A few misses at the stripe, and they're right there within range. You know, late game free throws are a lot different than early game free throws in terms of making them.
Two shots.
He drops the first one, and that puts them up by five. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a six-point ball game.
I think it's a wrap. When the game's on the line, he knows how to deliver the crushing blow. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Good! Man, it's always fun watching Harden get going. I mean, he can spray you from outside or slay you from inside. And it's usually pick your poison.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Good on the first, and that puts them up by five. And he is unable to get the second one. A shot by Harden, wide open. Trifecta!
Yeah, the range of Harden deserves a lot of respect because his form is really almost perfect. He's never off balance when he shoots the three-point shot. He's always got his legs under.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a three-point lead. And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good. So it's the Kings taking the W in a close one. They break the hearts of every fan in the building with a dramatic late victory.
And Kevin, this is the kind of win you have to take a ton of pride in. I mean, they battled with everything they had and came through when the pressure was at its highest.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Alden, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.